it's not uncommon for young women who've had treatment for breast cancer, treatment for gynecological cancer, so anything that really impacts on their hormonal status. And it's not unusual for young women to go into premature or early menopause, maybe not immediately after treatment for cancer, but perhaps a couple of years later, so much earlier than they would have naturally. And so what commonly occurs there is vulvovaginal dryness, which then results in pain with any kind of sexual touch. And there certainly are a plethora of lotions and potions out there. If you go into any drugstore, it's actually quite amazing at what there is now. And certainly those can be helpful. But I think that the help of a healthcare provider who's knowledgeable about this and can really guide them, anything that's warming, cooling, or exploding in terms of lubricants are not recommended. They contain irritants. And there certainly are other brands which tend to come and go, unfortunately. You know, they come on the market and then the next thing they go, or they change the packaging and they don't look the same. So those can be helpful. There are actually very few pharmaceutical interventions for women's sexual problems, including women with cancer as well as otherwise healthy women. Men get it a little bit easier. However, you know, pills, etc., don't always work, you know, depending on the treatment that the individual has gone through. So the help of a professional is really important. And once again, communication. You know, I think so many of us learn about sex through television, and that's not real, you know? Makeup on, slight glow, hair's not messy, nothing strange happens. That's not real life. And unfortunately, that's where a lot of people are getting their information.